Gute Siche ist Chelik Yud, Vayechi. Vayechi Aleph. This Siche is on a story, on a very classic story with the Tzemach Tzedek and the Alter Rebbe, brought in Hayom Yom Yud Ches Tevis. And in a certain sense, we're going to do to the story what we do to our Rashi. We're going to take apart, dissect the story, and understand that every prat in the story, every detail in the story, is relevant and is a lesson to us. So we begin with Eis Aleph. K'v'kdushus me'er v'chami admur siper, the Friedrich Rebbe related, v'yayis v'atzimach tzedek yelad, v'lomad as hakasu v'yichi Yaakov beret mitzrayim shvas v'shana. When the Tzemach Tzedek was a child and learned this pasuk that Yaakov lived in Mitzrayim for 17 years, Tirgim le'moyrei, his teacher translated or explained, Al pi pirush Baal HaTurim, according to the explanation of the Baal HaTurim, she'es yudzayin shneisav ha'muvchores chai Yaakov in Mitzrayim. Yaakov avinu had gilept the zibitzin beste yorin in Mitzrayim. Yaakov lived his 17 best years, not just that he lived 17 years, but 17 is begimatria toiv, which means good. So Yaakov's best years were in Mitzrayim. This is what the teacher taught the Tzemach Tzedek as a young boy. So when he came home, he asked the Zayde, the Alter Rebbe, how is it possible that Yaakov Avinu, who is the best of the Avos, as we know that the other Avos, that only Yaakov is Mitosa Shlema, and the Chassidus explains the Maila of Yaakov over the other Avos, but how is it possible that Yaakov, who is the best of the Avos, of the fathers of the Yidden, his best years should be the 17 years that he was in Mitzrayim, which is Erev HaSaaretz, the most immoral place of the world at that time. So the Alter Rebbe answered, "Ksiv." It says in the previous parsha, Parshas Vayigash, "Es Yehuda shalach lefonav al Yosef leheres lefonav geishna," that he sent Yehuda ahead. Literally, it means to find the way. V'isav medrash, but the medrash says, "Move a Rashi," and it's brought in Rashi. Omer Rav Nechemia lehaskin lebeis Talmud, that he sent Yehuda to establish a place of learning. The word lehoyros comes from the word of Torah, which is to learn. So Rav Nechemia says that he sent Yehuda to build, to establish a place of learning. Shetehesham Teire, there should be Teire in Mitzrayim. Vishayiyu Ashvatim Hoigim Bateire. And the Shvatim, the sons of Yaakov, the sons and the grandchildren, should be learning Teire. Leheiris Lefanav Geishna, Kishaleim Dim Teire. When we learn Teire, Leheiris, when you learn Teire, Miskarvim Lashem Yizbarach. You become closer to Hashem. The word Geishna is from the word to approach, to become closer, like the word Vayigash. So Lahaira is the fun of Geishna. When you learn Torah in Mitzrayim, or you learn Torah Bechlal, Geishna, you become closer to Hashem. The Loch in Haisa b'chinas Vayechi, Gam in Mitzrayim, and therefore he was able to experience a Vayechi in Mitzrayim. And here it is in Yiddish. As men learn Torah, vet men enter zum Ebershin Baruch, when you learn Torah, you become closer to Hashem. When Eich in Mitzrayim is given Vayechi, gelept. And even in Mitzrayim, he could be Vayechi, he could be alive. So that's the story. So he says in Eis Beis that the stories of the Rabbeim are precise. Every detail is important. Sipuri Rabbi Seinu Nisinu B'chlal, the stories of the Rabbeim in general. And specifically those that were given over to us, that were conveyed to us, that we should publicize them. Miduyakim heim, they are exact, they are precise. Ki yodua is known, b'chol prateim, every detail is precise. Haynu sheheim b'shaychas la'avonas teichen ha'sipur. Shekol prat negeya u'mesaya la'avonas klolos enyonei. First of all, you have to understand the story. Every detail in the story helps us understand the whole picture. V'heim b'shaychas la'musar haskel shev ha'sipur. And also with regards to the lesson, the takeaway from the story, shebechol prat, in every detail of the story, tumuna hayrav avedas Hashem, lies a lesson in our avedas Hashem. V'cheinu b'gam b'nitin didan. And so too in the case of this story as well. Koylil gam she'elas ha-tzemach tzedek, including the question of the tzemach tzedek, is also going to be relevant to understand the story and to the lesson that's taken from the story. Ki'av she'sha'alo b'yaldusa, even though he was a child when he asked the question, v'kol zeh, Nevertheless, two things. Number one, Mikivon Shegami Chelik Measipur Shenim Ser Lanu Al Yedei Rabbeinu Nesiyenu. Since it is part of the story that was passed down to us by our rebbes, Harei Bevadei Shegam Bo Teichen Rav Ubemele Gamei Rav Avedes Hashem. Clearly, it also contains depth and therefore a lesson. Number two, Bifrat Al Pimay Merazal Butzin Putzin Mekat VeYediyah. Especially according to what Chazal tell us, literally these words mean that the small cucumbers, even when they're not yet grown, fully grown, you could know what they're going to be like when they are going to be fully ripe. And the lesson Chazal learned from this, they use it as a metaphor, that sometimes you could see in a child what kind of person they're going to grow up to be. So that Tzemach Tzedek was a Rebbe. So even though he wasn't a Rebbe yet, but he was a child that was going to become a Rebbe. And therefore certainly, even in his question, lies depth and lies a lesson. And one more point. This explanation that the Alter Rebbe answers the Tzemach Tzedek was said to him as a child. So from this we can derive that the lessons taken from the story are applicable to everybody, even those who are still immature with regards to their level in Avodas Hashem and serving Hashem. Nevertheless, the whole story is with a child. So even if you are still a child, you can still gain and derive something from the story. So we have the story, the question, the answer, and we have this message that the stories of the Rabbeim, especially those that were publicized, given over to us for the sake of publication, certainly have a lesson, and every detail is important. So let us look a little bit deeper into the story and let us see what we have to understand, and then what we could take from the story. At first glance, there are a number of details that are not so understood in the story, in the message, and in the hemshech, in the story. Aleph. The first question we have is that the Alter Rebbe didn't answer the question. The question wasn't how did Yaakov end up in Mitzrayim. The question was how is it possible that his best years were in Mitzrayim? The answer of the Alter Rebbe was, the answer was that when you learn Torah, then even in Mitzrayim you could experience Vayechi. But it doesn't sufficiently respond and explain how you could have Vayechi in Mitzrayim in a way that it's the best years. The Tzemach Tzedek's question was, how could he have his best years in Mitzrayim? And the answer was, if you have Torah, you have Vayechi. What about the best years in Mitzrayim? He didn't address that, seemingly. Base, second question on the story. We don't know exactly how old the Tzemach Tzedek was, but he was young enough that he wasn't learning Balaturim by himself. He was hearing the Pirush of Balaturim from his teacher. So, which means he was at a fairly young age. In that case, why does the Alter Rebbe bring the drasha, the teaching of Chazal on this pasuk, from the Medrash, which is also brought down in Rashi? Why didn't the Alter Rebbe just reference Rashi? Therefore, you must conclude. That even though the Rashi, whatever is brought in Rashi, will answer the question, and that's why the Alter Rebbe mentioned Rashi. Notice that he says, "Medrash muva bepirush Rashi." So the fact that he says "muva bepirush Rashi" means that Rashi's pirush is enough to answer the question. But by saying the word "medrash," the kolzeh yitoysev bazeh aydei safashav medrash, the answer will be enhanced by the something that's found in the medrash. Therefore, the Alter Rebbe, even though you're talking to a child, he quotes the Medrash because the Medrash has what to add to the answer that we would take from Rashi alone. And what is that? Obviously, the question is, what are we learning? How is the answer being enhanced by the teaching of the Medrash, by the words of the Medrash? Gimel on our third question. Rashi brings the Maimer Chazal to establish a place of learning. From there, teaching will come out. Teira will come out. And that's the connection between the word Lahiris and Hira'a. Medrash Moisif Alzeh, the Medrash adds. Now the Medrash is before Rashi, but Rashi did not quote the entire Medrash. So there's more in the Medrash, and the Medrash says, V'sheyiyu ha-shevatim ha-yigim b'teira, that the Shevatim, the children of Yaakov, should study or study diligently in Teira. V'tzarech la'oven, kavon, esad mora zakin ha-yisal l'varech shemif chashnest of the Yaakov ha-yubim b'tzirayim. Altered, I was trying to explain the Yaakov's experience. The Yaakov's best years could be in Mitzrayim. So how does the fact that the Shvatim are learning Torah, how does that add to Yaakov's experience? How does that make Yaakov's experience better and the best of his life in Mitzrayim? In other words, the question is about Yaakov, and the Medrash is talking about the Shvatim. So why does the Alter Rebbe refer to the Medrash? And what is the Medrash adding by telling us that the Shvatim are learning Torah? So those are our three questions. Number one, seemingly the Alter Rebbe didn't answer the question. Number two, why does the Alter Rebbe refer to the Medrash? And number three, what is the addition to the answer by the words, V'sheyiyu ha-shvatim ha-yigim b'teira, if we're talking about Yaakov Avinu? So in Ois Dalet, he's going to begin to answer the question, but as we often do, we're going to first have to ask one more question that'll lead us into the explanation. And this question is going to be on the Tzemach Tzedek's question. What was he even asking about? He hadn't seen Yosef for 22 years. Yosef was his favorite child, or one of his favorite children. So now he's reunited with Yosef. Of course it's going to be his best experience. So that's what we're going to discuss in Ois Dalet. Yuvan ba'akdim teisves bir b'shelas ha-tzemach tzedek will understand the answer to all the previous questions by first trying to explain more elaborately the question of the tzemach tzedek. L'cheira ein l'tmei al etzem ha-davar. Asher mivchar shneisov shal Yaakov ha-yu davka ha-yu tzayin shonem ha-achreinis sheloi shehoyo b'yachadim Yosef. L'cheira, there's no question that why Yaakov's best years should be together with, to be in his last 17 years when he was together with Yosef. Kimuvanu pashut sheikir simchasei shel Yaakov. It's understood simply that the main joy of Yaakov, bechira avos, the best of the fathers, hoysal yedeza sheroa Yosef chai, was because he saw that Yosef was alive. Misnai kibenoi, and conducting himself as a child of Yaakov, Oymid bitzid kosei, still retaining and remaining in his righteousness. Gam la'achre himotzei zman oroch beret Mitzrayim, even after being an extended amount of time in Mitzrayim. When you came to Mitzrayim, or even beforehand, and you heard that Yosef, after 22 years in Mitzrayim, was still Yosef HaTzadik, was still conducting himself as a child of Yaakov Avinu, this is a major simcha. V'zeh, and this is not just something that we are speculating, but we see this in Rashi and in the Psukim. V'zeh gamuvim midivrei Rashi. This can be understood from the words of Rashi. V'bir sipur ha-kosov, when he explains the story of the pasuk, la'achash in his bath Yaakov ki Yosef chai, after the brothers came back from Mitzrayim, and they told Yaakov Avinu that Yosef is still alive. Vayofek libo, his heart was faint. He wasn't sure if he could believe it. And then it says, Ad kiva yada saw golis v'gemer. Then he saw the wagons. Vatchi ruach Yaakov aviyem. And the ruach of Yaakov, the spirit of Yaakov, was revived, was brought back to life. Now, Pipashtus, once he saw the agolis, he knew that something actually happened in Mitzrayim. And he knew, and this helped him believe that Yosef was alive. But what does Rashi say? Rashi says the simcha was much greater. When was his spirit revived? When was his life given back to him? When he saw the wagons. Why, says Rashi? Simin Mosalem Amelia Isik. These agolis, these wagons were a simin, were a sign to Yaakov in what he was learning when they had left Yaakov for the last time. The Parshas Egla Arufa, because they were learning Egla Arufa, the word agola is the same letters as the word Egla, just with different nekudos. So the agola, the wagon, was meant as a siman to Yaakov that he still remembers and is still involved in what they were learning together when they had departed one from another, which was the halachis of Egla Arufa. Zeu shenemar yaris agolis hashalach Yosef v'chulu. And that's why it says that Yosef sent the agolis, because he was sending this message that he was still involved, he was still learning. Harei. So Yaakov's primary joy and Yaakov's complete joy, when he saw that Yosef is standing on a high spiritual level, and his learning of Torah and his tzidkis, his righteousness, is as it always was. So we see from this Rashi that Yosef's simcha was from Yosef not just being alive, but being alive and involved in Torah and in Tzidkus. This also explains what Yaakov said to Yosef when he came to Mitzrayim. That now I'm happy because I saw your face, that you're alive. You have to see his face to know he's alive. Ella, shakavana bazelitzit kosei v'chayusi aruchni. His panov comes from the lashon pnimius, from his insides, from the depth, the truth of Yosef Atzadik. And he says, when he saw panov, when he saw who he really was, that his tzidkus and his chayusi aruchni is a spiritual. He was spiritually alive. Sheisara Yaakov v'fanov shol Yosef, that he could see in his face. And that's why, and this was the main reason why Yaakov was besimcha. So from this we understand that Yaakov's joy by seeing Yosef, and like we just explained, by seeing Yosef in a state of Yosef HaTzadik, of conducting himself like a child of Yaakov Avinu. So this was a joy and a lofty, a holy enjoyment, just like the greatness of light when it's transposed into the darkness, or when it's compared to the darkness, when it comes from the darkness, which we actually will discuss at length later on in the sicha. So when Yaakov saw Yosef and Mitzrayim in this situation. Yaakov was of great joy. So based on this, the Tzemach Tzedek's question and the elaboration of the Alter Rebbe's answer demand an explanation. Why did Tzemach Tzedek ask the question? It's clear why Yaakov was happy and why Yaakov was experiencing his best time ever. And why did the Alter Rebbe Meirich about the yeshiva starting in Mitzrayim? He should have said, Yaakov saw Yosef Eimid B'tzit Kasei, and therefore he was very happy. So, we had three questions. Why does the Alter Rebbe not seemingly sufficiently answer the question? Number two, why does the Alter Rebbe mention the Medrash? And number three, the Medrash speak about the Shvatim Hagim Bateira. How is that relevant to this conversation? So we understand that there's a much deeper dialogue going on here between the Tzemach Tzedek and the Alter Rebbe. And in order to understand that dialogue, we just introduced one more question, saying the Chayre, it's a very clear and simple what the joy was. The joy was to see Yosef after so many years, that even in Mitzrayim, Erev HaSa'aretz, he still aimed b'tzidkasa, he still retained his righteousness and his learning Torah, and therefore there's a big simcha. So what's the Tzemach Tzedek asking? So we have to truly understand what the Tzemach Tzedek was asking in order to understand what the Alter Rebbe was answering. And for that, we're going to go into Oisei. Mitzrayim comes, as explained numerous times in Chassidus, comes from the words mitzarim ugvulim, limitations and constraints, which means eretz she'eino nesenas makim legidli alakusi yisbarach abilti bagvul. It is a finite place, and therefore does not allow the revelation of alakus, which is infinite. Eibishter is higher than Gvul, beyond Gvul. So there's no, beyond Bli Gvul. So there's no room for bli gvul in the gvul of Mitzrayim. The Eid Yeser, on top of that, he ervas ha'aretz, it is literally, ervas means the nakedness of Eretz Yisrael, of the world, sorry, not Eretz Yisrael, of the land, mekoy machet, a place of sin, and the klipa, it conceals and covers up on any inyan eliki. Erva sara, just like an erva is supposed to be covered, so too, the idea of erva sara is that the klipas cover up on anything that's holy and good. So that's what Mitzrayim is about. Now, tachlis avedas adami, what is the purpose, the ultimate purpose of the person's aveda? Lotzeis mimitzadam gvulim elu, to go out of these limitations. Haynu sheyurgash etzlei gili ha'era liki abilti bagvul, that a person should experience the revelation of the infinite light of Hashem. Shal yideza yis'ala la'avedas Hashem b'li komedin zvagvalis, and this will elevate him that he could serve Hashem without limitations. As long as you're feeling limited, so your serving of Hashem is limited. But b'shas a person goes out of their Mitzrayim, which means to say that they're able to connect to the Eibishter habilti b'gvul, it's beyond gvul. Then you can also elevate yourself to serve Hashem without the limitations of Olam Hazeh. Now, based on this, v'zuhi nekuda she'losa she'latzam asadik la'ad morazakim. And based on this, now that we understand that Mitzrayim is about the limitations on the Gilui Alokus. And the whole purpose of the Avodah is to go out of those limitations. Now we can understand the question of Tzemach Tzedek. Hey, Nemesh Adavke B'yud Zayin Shana V'achrin Ez Bo'yankiv L'Simcha V'ein Egruchni B'madrei Genailis Kazu. Shle Higiya Ile Ad Oz. It's true that Yaakov was able to reach a level of Simcha of joy. V'ein Egruchni, and a spiritual gratification, enjoyment, on such a level that he never reached until then because he was seeing Yosef. Who was Eimid Bitzit Kasei, Ava Leidach. So beside the fact that he saw Yosef, that was a huge Simcha. But on the other hand, the fact that it was in Mitzrayim, which is Mitzrayim Mugvulim, which is limiting on Elokus, and is the Erev HaSa'aretz, a place where Klipas are covering up on the Giluyim, the revelations of Elokus. It causes a concealment and a cover, or at least it limits the ability to completely serve Hashem, which is to go out of the limitations of this world. The whole idea is that you should be able to feel a lakus that's higher than teva, that and bring it down into this world. But if you're stuck in Mitzrayim, then you don't experience that. Umitzadze eich efshir. How can you call this his best years? Especially if you compare it to his years in Eretz Yisrael, which was at a place that was befitting for the holiness of an Eretz Tmima, which was Yitzchak, who was the holiest of the holy, and therefore he couldn't go to Mitzrayim. He could only be in Eretz Yisrael, so clearly Eretz Yisrael is a much holier place, and a place that is not limited to limiting to the Gilui of Elokus Yisbarach. So Yaakov, when he goes down to Mitzrayim, Yaakov is now experiencing Mitzarim Ugvulim, a limitation on the revelation of the Eibishter, which is a limitation on his Avodah. So the Tzemach Tzedek's question is, how does Yaakov have his best years if he can't truly and properly complete his Avodah? There's a Meitzer Ugvul, there's a limitation on how much Gilui Elokus there could be in Mitzrayim, and therefore there's a Meitzer Ugvul on how much he can elevate himself and connect to the Eibishter. So now comes the answer of the Alter Rebbe. So Yaakov Hiskin Lebeis Talmud B'Mitzrayim. That Yaakov established a place of learning in Mitzrayim. And through Teira, even in Mitzrayim, you could be in a state of alive. Through the learning of Teira, which elevates and lifts up the person who's learning Teira beyond any limitations. It's possible even in Mitzrayim to reach the level of true life, life that's beyond the limitations of the klipas. V'hatam. Hateira, the reason for this is, Hateira Mushreshes Batzmusi is Baruch. The Torah is rooted in the Atzmus, in the essence of Hashem, in the Atzmus of the Eibishter. V'lachein k'shem sh'atzmusi is Baruch u'lamayla mikol ha'ktsov is d'mayla u'mata. Just like the Atzmus of the Eibishter is beyond the structure of higher and lower, it's beyond the limitations of above and below. Even when it comes down to in this world, in all the levels of Teda, even when it traveled downward, descended, and it became enclosed in physical. Physical things and articles of this world, which means to say, when you have sheres nagar chasapara, it's talking about a sheir, it's talking about a para. It's clearly far, far removed from the teda the way it is lamaila. But nevertheless, it's still the Eibishter's teda, and therefore, and it's still mushra shenatzmus, and therefore, our yibchin is bli gvul. Even when it's discussing yanim of gashmius, it is still infinite. The learning and connecting, attaching oneself to Teira has the power that through learning Teira, you become one with Teira in an unbelievable oneness. To be one and united from all side and every corner. So therefore, it has the power to elevate the person and remove him beyond all of the limitations and constraints of the world, and to undo the concealment of Mitzrayim. So since Yehuda was sent ahead before Yaakov, by Yaakov, to establish a place of learning that there would be Teira in Mitzrayim, therefore Yaakov's arrival in Mitzrayim did not qualify as a descent. Yaakov was not affected by the limitations of Mitzrayim. And now it's possible that even his best years should be in Mitzrayim. Because the fact that he has the simcha of seeing Yosef emet b'tzidkasei, and he's in Mitzrayim, but he's not limited by the mitzarim ugvulim from Mitzrayim, because he has Teira, and Teira is Mershash and Atzmus, and therefore Teira is Lama is Bligvul. Therefore Yaakov could experience his Avedas Hashem, together with the simcha of seeing Yosef, and Mitzrayim doesn't take that away from him. And therefore, it's possible that his best years could be in Mitzrayim. So that's the answer of the Alter Rebbe. Now we understand the dialogue a little bit better. The Tzemach Tzedek was asking, how do you serve Hashem? And Yankiv's whole union is to bring a Likus into the world. And therefore, how does he do it in Mitzrayim? And the answer is, Teira. That through Limud HaTeira, a person reaches the level of Bli Gvul, and therefore Yaakov wasn't limited by the Mitzarim Gvulim of Mitzrayim, and therefore he could continue to serve Hashem and do his Aveda. In Eis Vav, we are going to explain more elaborately how it is the best years. Because L'chaira, you know, Yaakov was, with regards to his Aveda, it wasn't a Yeridim, it's Mitzrayim, but it wasn't an Aliyah. So there has to be something that happens in Mitzrayim, I would imagine, besides seeing Yosef, that takes these 17 years and makes them Mivchash Noisav. And that's what he's going to explain in Eisvav. To explain how these years were Mivchar, were his best years. Muvaz, another Allah Pasik layers the fun of Geishna, Mimedish. Therefore, he brings the drasha of Chazal from the Medrash, Ima Isafa, Veshayu Ashvatim Hegim Bateira, with the Isafa, that the Shvatim should be Hegim Bateira, should learn Teira, Kinal Siv Gimel. So, In other words, technically the answer is already answered. Like we said in the question, that just from Rashi alone, the question is answered. Because we have the fact that Yosef was there in the Eimei B'tzidkasei, and you have the fact that the Metzarim Ugvulim are not there because you have the B'ligvul of Teira. So the answer is really answered. But to explain it better, about Mivchar Shneisav, we're going to learn that from the addition of the Medrash. And the addition in the Alter Rebbe's words to the Tzemach Tzedek from the Medrash, that the Shvatim should be Hoygim B'Teira. And to explain this, we're going to go into the inyan of Yisrael Na'erim and Achayshach, the advantage or the greatness of the light when it comes min Achayshach. And he says like this. Before he gets to that, he says like this. Vabir, ve'osi apostik va'inyan shashalat tzemach tzedek b'yosei yalad. The very same pasuk and discussion that the Tzemach Tzedek had asked about as a child, bir b'gadlusay. The Tzemach Tzedek explained it. Once he was an adult, a Rebbe. And it's brought in the Ratera. And it says that the Tzemach Tzedek said, that the Yaakov lived in Mitzrayim for 17 years. 17 is the Gematria Toiv, the word Toiv, which is good. The Hainu, Al Yidei Shva Esre, the Mitzrayim, through the 17 years of Mitzrayim, Zocha Lebchines Vayichi, he merited the level of Vayichi to be alive. Lirois toiv, to see good. Ki yistei na'er nimshech men acheshech. Because the greatness of the light is drawn from the darkness. We know that toiv and oir go together. That toiv means oir. So what does it mean that, he saw at 17 with kimisper toiv, that Yaakov merited to see the light? And it was a level of Vayechi because of the advantage, the greatness of light that comes min Achayshach. Finally, Ayidei Ayiridu leMitzrayim Zocha leYisin Ernim Shepun Achayshach. That because he went down to Mitzrayim, he merited the greatness of the Ur that comes from the Cheshach. Before he went down to Mitzrayim, he had the Ur. He had the Avedis Hashem, Bli Gvul, the Gili Alakusi Yisbarach. But by going down to Mitzrayim, he merited the greater light because of the fact that it comes from the Cheshach. V'hinei. In Ayizayim, we're going to explain what is Pshat Yisrael Ur Min Cheshach. And he's going to say it in two ways. One, he's going to say that the light is appreciated more in the darkness, and the greater the darkness, the greater the light is recognized and appreciated. Two, which this is the beer of Chassidus, that the Cheshach itself, the darkness itself becomes light, and therefore the light is a different kind of light. It's a better light because it is utilizing the darkness to as part of its light. And that's what we're going to say in Ayizayim. When we say that there's a greatness of light when it comes specifically from the darkness, there's two ways to explain it, which means to say there are two ways to experience it. One, that the place where it's dark is illuminated by the light. And the greater the darkness, it is more recognized, the greatness of the light and its infinite power, that it can impact even a place of such great darkness. So the greater the darkness, the greater we appreciate or understand the greatness of the light, that it's able to change and impact this darkness. Beis, the second way of understanding this, is that acheshech atzmai mu'or, the darkness itself becomes light, becomes illuminated, the ne'apach le'er is transformed into light, and this creates a addition or an advantage or a transformation in the light itself. That in the light itself comes a higher level that the light inherently didn't have. So before the light was just a light, now it's a greater light because it's a light with the darkness that was transformed into light. The hafresh in Bebeis Abiyur Melu. What's the difference between these two explanations? The fi biur ha'alef b'yisunayim and acheshach. According to the first explanation, that the light is more recognized and more appreciated in the dark, It doesn't mean that with regards to the light, there is actually an existence of darkness. That through the darkness, you could recognize the advantage of the light. No. Since the light is infinite, so it illuminates everywhere, even into the darkness. As far as the light is concerned, it doesn't know of the existence of darkness. So what does it mean the light is greater when it comes from the darkness? Is with regards to the place that is dark, if not for the light, over there there's an advantage because it was dark. And from the observer, the person who is seeing the darkness that is within the ramifications of understanding dark and light. So first he sees that it's dark, and then he sees that it's light, and he appreciates the light. So the yisrin ha'er is not in the er itself, because the er didn't even know cheshach exists. As far as the er is concerned, there's no cheshach. The er does its job, which is to illuminate. The place is dark, so the place will appreciate the light. The person is observing the darkness and now sees the light come in, so the person will appreciate the light. But as far as the light is concerned, there's no darkness. The darkness doesn't exist. That's according to the first view. Shaking the view base. But according to the second explanation, that the advantage of the light is coming from the darkness itself, not the comparison to the darkness, but the darkness itself is transforming, being transformed into light. Even the light has to acknowledge that darkness exists. And the light has to transform that darkness. And because of that, there is an added advantage to the light because it transformed the darkness. But the cheshach exists. So even though on the one hand, the second level is a much higher level because it's actually transforming the darkness. On the other hand, in the second level, the light has to acknowledge the existence of darkness. In the first explanation, the light doesn't acknowledge the darkness, doesn't know the darkness exists. It happens to exist. We know that it exists because we are in within the gedder of knowing dark and light. But the light itself, it does its job, it gives light. And based on this, that if you're telling me that there's two pirushim, in one, in the first case, there's no existence of cheshach, legabi the oir. And in the second case, there is an existence of cheshach, which the oir has to be mehapik, it has to transform. So based on that, pirush ha-pasik v'yichi Yaakov eretz Mitzrayim, when you explain the pasik that Yaakov lived in Mitzrayim, shal yidei ha-yirida li-Mitzrayim, zocha li-bchines v'yichi, that Yaakov himself merited a level of v'yichi, and himshik when ha-cheshach comes from the darkness. It doesn't say, like in the parentheses, v'loi shebi yosef mitzrayim akim ha-cheshach, hoysi nikeres la-acherim ala sachayim shaloi, so you gam shom atachas ilu. It doesn't just say that when Yaakov was in Mitzrayim, others could acknowledge or realize or recognize that Yaakov was living a lofty life. That it was in total, it was in the highest possible level. Doesn't say that. It says more than that. The Yaakov himself merited a vayichi, which came from the cheshach. Harei muvan shulafi biur bezanal. So it's understood that this is following the second explanation, that there was a mitzias of cheshach, which Mitzrayim, and that cheshach, because Yaakov was mahapich that cheshach by limudateira, therefore he himself, his quality of spiritual life changed to the level of vayichi. So now we have a different understanding of what is pshat, yisn erim and acheshach, and therefore what is pshat that Yaakov merited vayichi. That we're heading for mivchash noisav. That's why it's mivchash noisav. It's mivchash the best years because until he went to Mitzrayim, there was no yisn erim. There was only the er without the yisn erim and acheshach. And in Mitzrayim, there was a yisn erim and acheshach. Where do we see this nekuda? Where do we see this detail in the words of the Alter Rebbe? He said, when you have Torah, you have Vayechi Gelept. Where do you see in the words of the Alter Rebbe this nekuda that Yaakov experienced Yisrei Na'er Min HaChoshech in Mitzrayim, and that's why it was Mivchash Neis of his best years? This we're going to see in Oisches. And it's going to say that we're going to see this in the words, V'sheyiyu hashvatim hegimatir. Based on this, we're going to say the Alter Rebbe was specifically added in these words, to hint, to allude to this explanation. Where do we see this? So we have to understand like this. The Aves are on the level of Atzilus. Right, where Atzilus is beyond Chayshach. Even though there's Sfiris over there, which is already, it's the beginning of Seder Ha'ishtalshelus, but nevertheless, compared to Biyah, Atzilus of Le'igur Chara, there's no Chayshach. The Hashvatim, Miloshen Hamshach, Kechva Deshavit, the word Shvatim, which comes from the, similar to the word Kechva Deshavit, which means a shooting star, which is basically a star that's being drawn down, moving from place to place. The word Shevet comes from the word Hamshacha, which means to draw down. So when you say Shevatim, Hein Biyah, this is referring to the Elemes of Bria, Yitzira, and Asiya, which is already a level lower than the Avos, which are in Atzilus. They're already drawn down into closer to this world. The Lochein. As far as Yaakov himself is concerned, because Yaakov is on the level of Atzilus, which is the level of infinite light, and as far as Yaakov is concerned, there's no darkness. Yaakov is not affected whatsoever by the Metzarim Ugvulim of Mitzrayim, of the Metzias, of the Cheshach and Helam of Mitzrayim, because Yaakov is coming from Atzilus. And therefore, the Alter Rebbe adds the fact that the Shvatim were learning Teira. Since the Shvatim are from the worlds of Yetzirah, Asiya, Almin, the Preda, the worlds that are separated from Elokus somewhat. Over there could be darkness. So by learning Torah, by the Shvatim learning Torah in Mitzrayim, they were able to accomplish, to illuminate the darkness. Because as far as they're concerned, they could acknowledge the entity, the existence of darkness. And by transforming that darkness to light, they were able to experience the Yisun Ha'er, the advantage of the light that came from the darkness. So now we understand that the Alter Rebbe was, when he says the words V'shiyu Ashvatim Hegim Bateira, he was hinting to the fact that there was a Metzias of Chayishach and Mitzrayim which the Shvatim could experience because they were in Elam Izbiyah, which is already closer down to this Elam and further away from Atzilus, which is the Era Bilti Balgvul. And even the Shvatim are able to be Mahapa Chayishach La'er through learning Torah, and therefore they could experience Yisna Erbin HaChayishach. V'yav Shu Yisna Erbin HaZel La'er B'Yakev Etzad Atzmei. And even though Yaakov himself did not experience this, because Yaakov didn't know of the whole darkness of Mitzrayim, but the fact that Yaakov was the one who established, or was established for him, a place of learning, that there should be a place of Torah, and the Shvatim should be learning Torah, Paul shegam hu zochel lepchinas vayichi yisun er nimshach ben acheshach. Yaakov was also able to experience the yisun er, even though he didn't experience the cheshach, but he was able to experience the yisun er because he was the one that arranged and caused the ability for the shvatim to learn Torah. Ubedug mosay duas al de avede bebiyah misif meir batzilus. Just like we know that through avede bebiyah you can misif er natzilus, so too through Yaakov affecting that the Shvatim should learn Torah, this gave him as well the advantage of the Yisrin Ha'er, and therefore he could have the Mivchar Shnoisef. In the Arutz 33, he mentions the fact that the Alter Rebbe used the words Ha'igim Ba'Torah. In the Arutz 10, he asked the question that in other medrashim or other nuschois, it says loimdim in Bereshis Rabba or melamed. that he was teaching the Shvatim in the Yalkut Shemayni, it says Hoigim Batera. Hoigim means to learn diligently, to learn a lot. So now we can understand why the Alter Rebbe says in Aruch 33, why the Alter Rebbe used the word Hoigim, because Yistein Ha'er Menacheshech has to be with Yegiyah. Because when you have the Choshech, when your Seichel is challenged, you have to dig very, very deeply into your Seichel in order to understand something. Similarly, when you're miyageya in Torah, when you harve, when you toil, when you work hard in learning Torah, you're able to reach a much higher level, just like we know the advantage of Bavli, learning Talmud Bavli, over learning Talmud Yerushalmi. Talmud Yerushalmi is halachas. But Talmud Bavli, it says, b'machshakim ha'yishivani, it's like going through dark tunnels, because it's a question and an answer and an upreg, and you're learning, and it's deep, and it goes deeper and deeper, and you could almost lose your way from where you started from. It's harder, because you have to engage your brain and your intellectual faculties a lot more when you're learning Bavli. But because of that, there's a maila, that the light at the end of the tunnel is so much greater. So therefore, the Alter Rebbe learns, ha'yigim b'teira, because a yeis that the avedi is yisin ha'er min ha'cheshech, it has to be yigye, you have to dig deep, deep into the Cheshech in order to transform it into light. That's just a Ha'ara. And then in Ha'ara 34, and the fact that he says that by the Shvatim, they were able to bring earth from the Cheshech itself, he says, therefore you see that the Alter Rebbe used the words, as men led in Teira, that men nenter zum Eberschen Baruch Hu, which means nenter means closer. Closer means that you were further away and you got closer. In other words, it's possible that there should be a distance, and through Teira it becomes closer. And on the level of the Shvatim, since they were from Biyah, which Biyah recognizes the existence of Cheshech, therefore that there is a Richuk that has to become Kar of Yosef. So we've answered we understand the dialogue of the question of the Tzmich Tzedek. We understand the answer of the Alter Rebbe. The Alter Rebbe is answering that through Teira, which is Bli Gvul, you're able to override the Mitzarim Ugvulim of Mitzrayim. We also understand that it was Mifchash Neisav because of Yisrin Ha'er Min HaChesh. Yaakov experienced a Yisrin Ha'er which he didn't experience before he went down to Mitzrayim. We also understand why the Alter Rebbe uses the words to you, Ashvatim Ha'egim Ha'teira, to hint to us this idea of Yisrin Ha'er, that dafka by the Shvatim, which by them there is Metzias of Cheshech, there could be Yisrin Ha'er Min HaChesh, which of course benefits Yaakov Avinu, but it has to come from the Shvatim. So, far so good. The question is, the Alter Rebbe didn't say this explicitly. The Alter Rebbe hinted to it, by the words of Yishiyu, Ashvatim Ha'egim Ha'teira, he hinted to this idea of Yisrin Ha'er Min HaChesh. Because remember, when we learned the Sicha, that when he said the first part of learning Teira, he didn't go into Yisrin Ha'er. He said that b'shas you have Teira is bleak vul, mekeach ha-Teira, to mevatel the alamis v'asteira of Mitzrayim, and therefore you could have a vayichi. Only afterwards did he add the idea of Yisrin Ha'er Min HaChesh, and he said that it is alluded to in the words of the Alter Rebbe from the Medrash, v'shayiyu ha-shvatim ha-egim ba-Teira. So the question now is, no istes, why does the Alter Rebbe not say it explicitly to the Tzmach Tzedek and only hints to it or alludes to it in these words of the Medrash? And what he's going to say in Nois Tess is very interesting. He's going to say when you talk to a child, you don't want to speak about Yisrin Ha'er Min HaChesh. You'd rather just speak about the Eir. You'd rather just tell him, do positive. The idea that Cheshech is going to exist and you have to have a Yisrin Ha'er Min HaChesh, this is not something that you'd rather not tell this to the child or to the beginner. Ice test. Pisa kam yuvanata mashad mura zaken leyam abiras of a fetish. This will also explain to us the reason why the Alter Rebbe does not say this clearly. The mashal of Megillat Tzmach Tzedek in a mashal that would be understood to the age of the Tzmach Tzedek, in Beremez, he only hints to it. Because say that Avedis Adam Tzarech Li is Beifan Yasher. The order of a person's aveda preferably should be in a straightforward way. First, sur mira cheshech, first turning away from the ra with the darkness, va'asei. Aveda be'efenu bedavar shumu lechatchila olulu mukhshir liyeis tever. And your positive aveda should be in something that lechatchila is capable and prepared for being light and good. In other words, the first thing you want to tell a person is stay away from the darkness and focus on the good. Do light, work with light. And even though through a person's aveda, overcoming challenges, when he has distractions or things that are disrupting his fulfillment of Torah and mitzvahs, and he overpowers, he overcomes it, and he withstands the challenge, and this elevates him to a higher level which he wouldn't have reached without the challenge, without the test. We find that through tshuva, you could transform his deliberate sins, his avedas, into merits. Which basically, you're taking an aveda and you're turning it into something, to a schus. Is like the second oifin mentioned before, that the actual choshech becomes light. So even though this is true, that when you overcome a challenge, it picks you up, it lifts you up. And your zedoynus can become zachis. And it calls a b'di'evet. This is only post facto. Once he ready arrived, was brought into a spiritually dangerous situation and survived. This elevates him to a much higher level beyond where he was standing in his previous level. So too, if we're talking about Zdenis Naso Kizachiyes, a person that already sinned, Rachman al-Islan, if he does a proper tshuva, Ah, Zdenis Naso Kizachiyes, to the point that his Averis become mitzvahs, becomes chiyas, he could reach such a high, lofty level. Chazal tell us that the place where the tzaddikim gemurim, where a tzaddik stands, where a bal tshuva stands, I'm sorry, a tzaddik gemur can't even reach there. Because this is someone who already sinned. He already sinned, he was stuck. So now he's got to do tshuva. If he does tshuva properly, he could reach this incredibly high level. A person should never place themselves into a place of danger. You're not allowed to place yourself in a situation that's going to test you or challenge you. The place where it's possible that you're going to reach, it's going to cause you to sin. And certainly one shouldn't sin in order to do tshuva. We daven every day. Do not bring us into a place of a test. We want that even the ask Hashem should not bring us to a nisayin. Even though there's an advantage to overcoming the nisayin, we still ask the Eibishter, don't bring us there, because we don't want to be in a place of sakana. We don't know if we're going to survive, and even if we know we could survive, we're not allowed to endanger ourselves. It's not the right thing to do to explain to a child who is still in the age of chinuch, a young age, that there is an advantage to be getting involved with darkness because you could transform into light. When you're talking to a child, when you're talking to someone who's in the beginning of their aveda, you have to focus and emphasize to stay away from the darkness, to stay away from the bad. And therefore, the Alter Rebbe tells it to the Simach Tzedek only in a remez, only in a hint, because it's not really something that you should be telling a child. Later on, when the Simach Tzedek was an adult, he was a Rebbe. So then the aesthetic himself explained it, the Yisrael Ermin HaChoshech explained it himself once he was old enough to understand this idea that when you go into Mitzrayim, there's a Yisrael Ermin HaChoshech. But when the Tzimach Tzedek was still a child, the Alter Rebbe specifically does not tell him the advantage of the Aved of the Yisrael Ermin HaChoshech, because he wants to speak to him, Beseder of the Oifin Yashu, the straightforward Aved, which is Sur Merah, and only is totally staying away from the Cheshech and totally focusing only on the Nyanim of Oir. So, this is the story. This is the story that the Tzemach Tzedek and the Alter Rebbe, and now we have an entirely new level of understanding of the story. Every prat in the story, the words, the question of the Tzemach Tzedek, the answer of the Alter Rebbe, the words the Alter Rebbe shows in the answer, the Medrash, the Rashi, every prat in the story, it's almost like a Rashi Sicha, where every word in Rashi is Meduyuk. So here you have every detail in the story is Meduyuk for us to understand what was happening over here. And we said earlier that it's not just in understanding the story, it's also in the Musar Haskil. Also the Hira of the story is also going to, every detail of the story is going to give us a Hira. And that's what we have in the next couple of Asiyos. Asiyot. Hira Klolis Bavedis Hashem B'Sipur Anal. Afal Pishu Yaki, the general Hira that could be learned in our Avedis Hashem from the story. Even though Yaakov Avinu, seeing the fact that Yosef and his family were conducting themselves in the proper way, this caused Yaakov great joy. Im calls that Tamach Tzemach Tzedek. Nevertheless, Tzemach Tzedek wondered, Eichi Tochen Leimer Shashanim Elu Shinim Tzeba Mitzarim Vagvulim Deretz Mitzrayim Tiyena Mivchash Neisov. How is it possible that these years that Yaakov was within the limitations and constraints of Mitzrayim should be his best years? Vayinu Mishum Shetachles Hakavon Avidah Zene Shomahi Shodim Al Yidei Aved Dosim In Lachatchila Liyev Mitzarim Vagvulim. Because the whole purpose of Aved is that a person should not be in the Mitzarim Vagvulim Yivrach B'chipoz and take advantage of Mitzrayim. A person should really be running away from Mitzrayim. Already right over there we have a Hira. The Hira is that a person, if possible, should always run away from Mitzrayim. That was the Tzemach Tzedek's question. Lidach Gisa, on the other hand, Ve'im kvar nimtzer b'meitzer gvul v'niyach livrech misham. If a person already finds themselves within these constraints where the klippas are blocking the Gilui HaLikus and he can't get away from there, Aveda sehi shasham yim yivchash neisof. His Aveda is, make that place your best years. If you can get away, like the Tzemach Tzedek's question. If you can't get away, then that is the place that has to be your best years. And how do you make that place your best years? Is understood in the answer of the Alter Rebbe, the Pashtus Amayna Shalai, in the basic understanding of the answer. He's talking to those that are still in the straightforward path. Created the person upright. That even those who, because of the Eibishter's decision and their shlichus in this world, they find themselves amongst the mitzarim agvulim, the constraints of Elam Hazeh, the limitations of Elam Hazeh. Even such places, that even within Elam Hazeh itself, is considered Erbas Haaretz, the lowest, the most immoral parts of the world. Aleim Lodas, they have to know. Their Aved is not just to refrain from falling. Elagam, La says dearly is but a patachtainim. The Aveda is to bring the Eibishter down into this world. Hamshachasa atzmus abilti bagvul. Gam bi imotzam. Besechichi mitzrayim mehamitzarim vagvulim shalai vesaretz. To be able to bring down the essence of Hashem, of the infinity of Hashem, even while being in the constraints of Erbes Haaretz. Veitzayutz alazehi. And how do you do that? Hatayra. Shalayidei limud hatayra. Shigidli chachmas yirtzeni yizbarach shalamayla mehagbolet vishinuyim. By learning Torah, which is the revelation of the Eibishter's Chachma, the Eibishter's wisdom, the Eibishter's will, which is beyond Hagbalas, beyond limitations and beyond changes. This Torah gives you the strength to rise above these limitations and these constraints. Not only Mitzrayim won't bring him down and limit him, If you learn Torah, and through Torah your mamshich the Eibishter abilti balgvul into El Mazah Gashmi, this gives you to the level of Vayechi, true life, even in Mitzrayim. So that's the first part of the answer. The answer in the Pashtos Amayna, in the basic understanding of the answer. They were saying like this: if you can stay away from the Ra, go right ahead, run away. But if you're stuck in the Ra, make this your best years. How do you make this your best years? By bringing down the Eibishter Adinu B'Tachtenim. And how do you do that? Through Limud HaTorah. Ulam Kozal Ulel Chayashar. This would refer to those who are walking on the straight and narrow, shall you day have a dose and believe without Torah, einam nesudim meyikarat hachashlita samitzarim bukvulim deres mitzrayim, because they're learning Torah, they are not bound by the control, the rulership of the mitzarim bukvulim, the limits and constraints of Mitzrayim, and therefore they could learn Torah and bring a lekus into the world. Aval eilu shechatu pagmu vavaru tzaderach, those who sinned, those who have walked or gone off this straight and narrow, Nachman Linslan, Shalachir, Kvarnaflutach, Sashlita, Solamit, Sarmagulin, and Tzrayim, they already have fallen under the rule, under the control of Mitzah, the Mitzahim, Mugvulim, that at Tzrayim, Echav Shalam Lagil of Chinis Vayachi, how are they going to reach Vayachi? How are they going to be alive? For this, there is an answer. In the answer of the Alter Rebbe, but only as a Remez, Elis, Yais, Chas Vashalom, don't despair. Kalyidei Avedis Atshuva. Through tshuva, which means to work on oneself within the dark place itself, not only will he go out of the darkness, he'll actually transform the darkness and reach an even higher level. And since the ultimate and true advantage of the oyer comes from the cheshech, ula yita atoye ha'elech, ula yita ha'elech yasha, leimer elech ve'evid avidos isham. So a person might say, let me go to the darkness. Let me go to the place of darkness because I could transform the darkness and uplift it. Chein rom mazad muradak in yilizeh. Therefore the Alter Rebbe only hints it. V'leom ribeferish, and didn't say it clearly. Shazabo leheirish she'ein zu aderech ha'yishar ha'shev v'liodom. To choose to go to the darkness is not the proper path that a person should choose. Says in the Mishnah that if a person says, I'm going to sin in order so I could do tshuva afterwards, then he doesn't have the opportunity to do tshuva. Which explains in the Geresa Tshuva, it's not so simple. He could push through tshuva, but it's not the way to go. Which means basically if a person tries to sin in order to reach the level of tshuva, he's going to fall. He's not going to pick himself up higher. So you shouldn't look for it. Therefore, it's a remez. But if you do end up there, then there's a remez in the words of the Alter Rebbe, that if you'll fight, in other words, fight, if you'll transform the work with the cheshach, and transform the cheshach, then you can have a yisner and a cheshach on even a higher level than the Heilich Yasher. So the person's going to come and complain. Why should he lose out? If the person that's going that ended up in the darkness has the ability to reach Yisrei Na'er, and the one who's the Heilich Yasher can't reach that high level, he's going to say it's not fair. Even the answer to this question is hinted in the answer of the Alter Rebbe. Commission is Bar Lehel. We said earlier in the Sicha, Yaakov himself was not able to reach the Yisnei Men HaCheshech Atzmei because Yaakov didn't know of the Cheshech. Yaakov was beyond the Cheshech. And therefore Yaakov couldn't reach the Yisnei by himself. Since Yankiv was involved in bringing to the fact that the Shvatim should learn Torah, he was able to also reach Vayechi Yaakov on the highest level, even though he didn't know the Cheshach and he didn't transform the Cheshach. But because he was worked with the Shvatim that they should learn Torah and they should be Mahapech the Cheshach, the same thing applies to the Aved of every Yid. When you are involved with those who are temporarily distant from the Eibishter and his Torah, lekarvam, to bring them closer, v'la'aseisam ba'li tshuva, and to make them into ba'li tshuva, since you caused, you affected on the other person, that they should have the advantage of tshuva, yesh lechelek b'yisin ha'er shel chaveira, he too, or you too, can experience the yisin ha'er, because you caused that the other person should have the yisin ha'er and experience it. So, if you're a Heilich Yasher, you should be a Heilich Yasher. And you shouldn't look for Cheshach. Are you going to say, how do I reach Yisner Menach Cheshach? Find someone else who is still in a Matzav of Cheshach. Help them be mahapich their cheshech le'er, and that will give you the advantage of Yisrael ben ha'cheshech, just like Yaakov had the advantage of Yisrael le'er, that it was mivchar shnoisim, it was his best years, even though he himself was a heilach yasher. And on the level of heilach yasher, and the shvatim were the ones who were involved in the ishabcha of the chashoich le'er. I day call them through this aveda of being mekarev those that are that are leisata rechaykim. Al day call them mekarev and bias Mashiach. This brings closer the coming of Mashiach. I just want to mention out of 45, he says the pirush of shnayim echzim betalis. The Kesher Shem Tov explains that if two people are holding on to a nitzutz, two people are holding on to something, and they're both come to lemaila and they're both claiming both neshamas. Are claiming that they were mevare that nitzos and they should get the aliyah from that nitzos. So the Mishnah says, they divide the talis. Then both nitzutzes get the advantage of both neshamas get the advantage of the bitter. So that's a raya or a smuchin to this idea that when you are pale on another yid yisner min acheshech, then you too gain a yisner in your own life. Adei kol zeh mekarev in bias haMashiach. This brings the coming of Mashiach. The asher la'asva tzadikaya b'tiyufta, which Mashiach is going to bring the tzadikim to do tshuva, where you have both milas. Side will be a tzadik, and side will have the mila of about tshuva. This is when Mashiach comes, and when we do this aveda, that even person is a helich yasher, is makar of other yidden, he has the mila of tzadikaya, and he has the mila of tiyufta. This will bring Mashiach. This will be makar of bias Mashiach, which then Mashiach will also bring tzadikaya b'tiyufta.